must be so...
Vin Diesel. I don't believe this. Over 3,000 channels and still nothing on. Huh? What's this?
Would you like to learn how to record at home so you can get your music out to the rest of the world?
Yes.
Stay tuned.
Hello everyone, Dave here from Sonic Corp Studios, and this is the Rework video for Ultimate Guitar's riffs and recording section. Basically, this is going over video 1 again, but I'm redoing it and making it a lot more professional and a lot easier to watch than the other one. That one was a little bit boring. So let's get started. We got a ton to cover. Basically, let's go over some questions that recently pop up and keep popping up around the message boards. The first is, do I need a mixer to record? No, you do not need a mixer to record. You can simply use an audio interface, which has a preamp, it's got phantom power on most of them, and the mixer has its place in studios, and I can see where some of you think that a mixer is needed to record, but the audio interface is what's in most studios today. They come in a wide variety of input and prices as well. First, let's start out with the computer itself, and this is basically your DAW or digital audio workstation. This could be a PC or a Mac, desktop or a laptop computer. Either one will work. I'm not gonna tell you to go with a PC or a Mac computer. Either one will work. Choose what you're comfortable working with. Audio interfaces. These are pretty much the essential part when it comes to recording. If you're thinking about recording, these are what you should be looking into. Basically, they are a high-end sound card made to record. They have proper inputs, they have preamps, they got AD converters on them, which is an analog to digital converter. Everything you'll need to start recording, and they simply link to the PC using FireWire or USB. So they come in FireWire or USB. Let's start out with what you should be looking into depending on your setup. If you have a small studio and you're only planning to record up to 2 microphones at one time, or in general just 2 microphones, go with USB. Anything 2 microphones or under, you'll be fine with USB, because the thing with USB is everything over 2 inputs on mono source will start to mix down. So if you tracked 4 microphones onto a USB interface, it's going to mix them all down, so you can't adjust that one microphone that you wanted to add reverb to. It's impossible. If you wanted to track more than 2 microphones at one time or 2 instruments at one time, you would want to go FireWire. It can hold a lot more data at one given time period, and it won't mix anything down. The PreSonus FP10, you can link 3 of these units together, and one of them has 8 inputs. So you can link 3 inputs, 3 of these units together, and send all of those tracks down to the computer unmixed, and it's outstanding. Basically, with USB, you have 1.1 and 2.0. It's like night and day, guys. Go with USB 2.0. That's my suggestion. They're not that much more expensive, and it's very well worth the price. The Line 6 tone ports, the UX1, the UX2, the GX, and I think the KB47, if I'm not mistaken, those are all 1.1 USB interfaces. They try to trick you saying they're 2.0, but if you are searching in the market and you're looking for an interface, if it doesn't specifically say that it is a 2.0 USB interface, don't believe any of the tricks. It has to state that it is a 2.0 USB interface. If it doesn't, it's most likely a 1.1, and generally you'll want to stay away from those. Sequencers. Basically, a sequencer is a piece of software that you're going to load onto your digital audio workstation. They take all the information, all the audio, and it puts it into a graphical form on your computer screen that you can easily work with. You can add effects, you can work with the virtual instruments, you can change the audio, the timing, and endless possibilities with sequencers today. I'm sure you've all heard of Cakewalk Sonar. I'm sure you've all heard of Audacity, which is a free program, and everyone knows about it, pretty much. That is a great starting program, but it does have its limits. It doesn't work with MIDI much either. Reaper is the next step up. It does fully support VSTs. It works well with MIDI, and overall just an outstanding program. It does take some time to learn though. Some of the higher end programs are Cakewalk Sonar, Cubase, and Pro Tools. If you're looking for a sequencer, I can suggest that you go to all these sites, download a free trial, usually it's a 30-day trial, and see which one you like best, and go from there. If you like one in particular, stick with that one and learn it. You do have to learn these sequencers. There's a steep learning curve to most of them. There's no easy way around it. You just gotta stick with it. And the more you learn, the easier it is to work with in the future, and the more interesting sounds you can do. So that's another tip there. Microphones, you got condensers, you got condensers and dynamics I'm going to talk about today. Dynamics are very popular. You'll see them all the time on a live stage setting when you have a singer. The Shure SM57, which is used for instrument miking, such as drums or guitar cabinets. That is a dynamic microphone. The Shure SM58 is a vocal microphone. It's also dynamic. Both are industry standard microphones. Great for $100 at each. Condensers. We have the MXL 990, 991. We have a Rode NT1A. All are great. The MXL set sells for $100 and you get two microphones normally. I'm using 991 overhead right now and it sounds outstanding. The thing about condensers is they need a extra little step. If you're going to be running a condenser and you're buying an audio interface at the same time, make sure you get phantom power on board with your audio interface. They do make phantom power boxes for external add-ons, but generally you want to get it on board for the convenience. This is basically 48 volts DC and it's used to power the microphones. Without it, you cannot run the microphones. Both dynamic and condensers do need a preamp though, and these are usually included on the interfaces today. So that's pretty much it, guys. You need hardware, you need software. Find which suits you best. Go through Tweak's guide at thestudiocentral.com. Outstanding guide. I'll put that in the credits and on the lower third right now. I'm Dave from Sonicorp Studios. I want to thank Studio Central for Tweak's guide. I want to thank YouTube for hosting all these videos. I hope you take down the 10-minute limit because I don't like that much. I want to thank UltimGuitar.com for letting me link to these videos and just generally let me help out over there. And keep on rocking, everyone. Thanks for watching my videos. Stay tuned. I got a lot coming out soon. Stay tuned for future videos. See you then.